Hi, good morning. So today we are doing a small repair job. This is here a control of a trolley that I have here in my hay barn. So pushing down, goes down and pushing up, it goes up. But as you can see, the emergency stop here is broken and this here came loose. So we will print a new case, a 3D print a new case, and we will add a new emergency stop. So here to make the control, the enclosure, I have an enclosure template. I will add the link in the description on how to make this template. I followed the tutorial of Adafruit, if I remember well. So we will take the one with the four notches. As you can see here, the case has four notches, 1, 2, 3, and 4, at the other side also. And they snap into each other. So that's a good way of fixing the lid with the cover. It's reasonable, it's working well. For such a big case, it's a little bit loose, but I think it will work well. So first thing we do, we save the template and we save it there in that location, and we will call it S control versi, I think it's 3. We'll close this one again. And then we go to the saved copy. And then that's the one we saved now. We open it. So that are the one we saved. First thing we do, we adapt the dimensions. It's with the parameters, so it's very easy to adapt the dimensions of your design. 200, and the width will be 50, I think. Yes. And the height will be 50 as well. Then the shell is the thickness of the case. It will be 1.5 millimeter, and the gap, that's the spacing between the notches, so that they snap into each other. But you will see that when you follow the tutorial I will add in the description. Okay, now we will add the openings into the box. We will add here one opening for the cable through, and then two openings on the bottom of the case. So let's start by the case, body. That's still a mistake in my template. We call it case, and then the body, we call it lid. Let's first hide the lid, and then we select the case as the active component. Then we take from the right side, and here we will make opening for the cable through. We select this face, right click, create sketch, and we will call it cable through. So we will add a line as a constructor in the middle of this face. Select the line and then click X. So that's a constructor line. Now we will add a circle, S key, and then circle here in the diameter. And that will be diameter 16, that's for our cable through, and now we will add the dimension from there to there. It will be the height, that's one of the parameters of the box, divided by 2. So that hole will be always in the middle. That's for that. Now we will select this face and we will cut it through to the other side. We click E and then we will make it a cut through and extend type to object, and then we select the other side of this face. Okay, so that should be the cut through there, 16 millimeter. Now we go to the bottom, that's the bottom. I don't know where the cable through is, it's a little bit difficult. It's there, yeah. So that's the bottom. Now we will add here 2 openings. So again, we will select here this case, bottom, create sketch, and we will call it controls, cut, out. I think the opening is here. Still confused, I don't know exactly how to see it, where the opening is. Opening is there. So, okay. We will add a line again to have the middle. You see the triangle there? That's the middle, the triangle. We select the line and we make it a constructor. Okay. Now we will add with the S key, we select the center circle there, and it will be 22.5. That's for our emergency stop. And now we add the dimension from there to there, and that will be the length of the case divided by 4. So that will be on 5 centimeters from the 5 centimeters from the top. Now we will add a centered rectangle here, and the height will be 30.5. Yeah, and the width, where is the width? Where is the width? I don't know what happened there. Let's do that again. So we will add here I was not able to give in the width. Why not? I don't know. Okay, the width was 22.5. not sure about those dimensions. I will add them. I will measure them again. And now this one will be the length divided by 2. Let's go remeasure those dimensions because I'm not certain. Yeah, the dimensions are correct. So that's, we finish the sketch and then we select them both. Then we extrude them, cut through. And that the distance will be to an object, and that will be the other side of the case. Okay, so that's it. We have our two cut-throughs, so it's looking good. Okay, now we can export the files for 3D printing. If we top cover lid, yeah. Top cover for this case. Why doesn't he show the lid? I don't know. Top cover bodies sketches. Ah, here, maybe this one. Yeah. So that's the complete thing. So now we are going to tools, make 3D print. Select the top cover. Okay. And then we will, in the right directory, we'll call it the lid. We say yes. That's the lid. And now we are exporting 3D print. Select. We will maybe hide the lid. That's the case. This one has to be unselected. Okay, and then we will call it the case. Override, yes. So that's the fusion. Now we are going to open the slicer. Oh, no. Open the wrong one. Open the wrong program. That's the Eagle Autodesk for PCB design. Wait, we wait until it opens. Prusa slicer. So now we are going to import the STLs. First we take the lid. That's the lid. We are going to reverse it by 180 degrees so that the notches are printed at the top, as we have to add support. That's good. Slice. And export the G-code. Exported, file, new, we remove everything, file, import, we import the case, that's our case, with the two openings there, and the cable opening at the right side, so that's good, slice it, 5 hours, export G-code. So that's the G-code exported. So here we have the Prusa printer. I copied the files already on the SD file. So now we say copy from print from SD. And then we take the case first. So now it's heating. This was one of my previous designs. I wanted to solve it with three buttons, and I tried to print some letters on the casing, and it worked out. But then the front layer was not so good. But that's normal, I think, because he had to print some supports to print the front layer, so that didn't work out so well. But now I made a new design, the one we are printing now. It's smaller and we will reuse the button on the old control. So he's now at 85 degrees bed heating and 230 degrees for the nozzle heating. I'm using PETG as material, and I used a normal window cleaner spray box to clean the bed. That's working well for me, for PETG. Now it's verifying the positions of the bed. So far I have just a few problems with the printer, but I could easily fix them myself. One of the bearings came loose, so it didn't print it straight. But for the rest, it's a remarkable, very good printer. So he's off now for a 5 hours and 20 minutes job. Let's come back when he finished. So guys, here we are with the two 3D printed parts. That's the case and the lid. And as told, they snap into each other with those snaps there. So if you place them there, and they snap into each other. So that's easy. And to undo them, you go in there with your nails or with a small screwdriver. and you can normally easily open them again. So first thing, so we are going to replace this one into the new case. First thing we do is to add the cable pass through. It's not done. And then we add a telemechanic holder for the emergency switch. You place it on top. Let's see how it goes. We have here an arrow there that should go into the arrow on the casing. So it should go arrow down. Like so. And now we use a screwdriver to screw them together until we make it straight, and then we screw it tight, but not over tight. So that's the emergency stop. That's that. Now we are going to remove the switch. So to do that, the power is off. I switched off the power, so we can undo this one. The red and the blue will go to the underside of the normal closed contact. And then those two wires, we will have to cut them. So let's maybe make them a little bit longer so that we don't have to make them bigger. This one we will leave it, I think, because the wire will be maybe too short. Yeah, we'll leave it. Well, I think we just remove everything here. Then we start from a clean connection. Let's be careful. Maybe the color of the wires are different. So let's be careful. So we cut it here, then it's definitely long enough. So if we can untie this one. Can we push it through? Maybe. Yes, we can. Okay. So now we can remove the push button. That's up and down. So we push it again in the same way. It should fit. Nice. First time. It's a long time ago. Okay. Now we will add again the two closed contacts, telemechanic contacts. That's so. And then the other one, like so. And then we reconnect the wires as they were. So we will put this one, the red one, we will put in the bottom. It's a little bit dark in here, but it will be okay. And the blue one will go at the bottom. That's so. And now we have to connect the black one. But we have to be careful in here. Maybe this one has maybe other colors than this one. So we have to be careful what we do. Let's try to open it. Careful, boy. You have to be careful. It's one black. It came loose already. Let's be careful. Don't pull so that we don't pull too much. One came loose already, you see? It's really too dark in here. I don't see very well. So, blue goes to blue, black goes to black. So, we have blue, and then we have blauw, zwart voor black, then gray and yellow. Blue goes to blue. Black goes to black, but there are two blacks, so it is black number. Hope they are numbered. They are not. Are they? No. There are two blacks. Okay. So it's black long, because that one is longer than that one. The gray goes to brown, and the yellow goes to blue-green, or green-yellow. I don't know who made this. You're still in my younger days, I think. So that's how it is connected. Okay. Verify once more. Blue-blue, black-black, the longer black. Gray to brown and yellow to green yellow. That's okay. So now we can cut them off. And we can make this one here a little bit longer, so it's easier to work with. Cut them off like so. Okay. That's loose end for construction. We can remove it. And this is the part we don't need, so we do it like so. And that's the long block, so it's those four that we need. So we can add them in the pass-through. So they are long enough, so that we don't have to make them longer. And the blue and the black, this one we don't need, we will insulate it for later. The blue and the black goes to the upper side of the normal closed contacts. I don't remember which side I had the picture. I have taken a picture of it. Let's try if I can check my pictures. The black is going to the side of the red, and the blue is going to the side of the blue. So the black is going to the black here, and the blue is going to that side. So we remove the insulation of the wire. Some furrows here. So that the wires, stranded wires, are kept nicely together. Excess of stranded wires. So the black is going to the side of the red. Like so. And the blue is going to the side of the blue. Like so. We will move the cables out of the way. The black one we don't need, and we will insulate it with a WAGO connector, so he will not make any shorts. And then we still have the two other ones, we will add them together here. So we can cut them off more or less there, and then we will add some stranded wires, protections. Okay. This one is a little bit strange. I'll make a new one. So that we have all standard wires. Make sure they are all in there. And we do the same for the other ones. My eyesight is not so good anymore. They're in? No, they're not in. You can do that so. Shorten the remains of the stranded wires, like so. Okay, with WAGO connectors, we connect the gray with the brown wire, and then we connect the yellow with the green yellow wire. So that should be it. So that's a bit, that's not so good there. It came loose or what? The furrow is a little bit too thick for the wire. To make sure it's well 15 there. Okay, so black side of red, blue connected to the blue, gray to the brown, and yellow to the white yellow. That should be it. We close the box and we can switch on the power again. It's not high enough or what? It comes against the, no, it should work. Should be fine. Okay, that's it. Let's connect the power. Okay, so push down. Yeah, if you push down, so if we push the button down, then the platform should come. Where is the platform? I don't see it. Oh, it's up there. What is this? Why is it not filming? Then the platform is coming down. If we push up, then the platform is going up. Huh? And if we push the emergency switch, nothing happens. That's good. So that's working.
Okay, that's a repair done. Why is it reversed again? I don't know, my camera is inversed. I don't know, what's that for thing again? So let's check it, if we push the button down. And if we push it up, then it pulls up, and if you push the emergency switch, nothing happens. Okay, guys, that's the repair video done. I hope you liked it, and I see you next time.